Hello. Today's topic is organizing your data for personal versus archival workflows. In this video, we'll go over what to consider when organizing your language documentation data for deposit to an archive. Preparing and organizing your work for deposit into an archive can be a daunting project. You have hopefully found a data organization system that works well for you and any team members that need to access those materials. But when you move those materials to an archive, you open up that access beyond those individuals. Digital language archives are designed to preserve language data and to make those materials accessible to users, which may include the depositor, but will also include other individuals such as other researchers, language speakers and community members, and future historians. With that in mind, here are some things to consider when organizing your materials. Collection. Many language documenters go out into the field, collect a wealth of audiovisual materials, and transfer them to another device for later analysis. Cameras and other recording devices will automatically assign sequential names to the files created, so you may need to give them more meaningful names once they are on a different device, like a computer. In that case, make sure you track any name changes, especially if you have any other documents related to those materials, such as field notes. Importing. When importing audiovisual materials to a computer, your computer may automatically add them to a generic music or video folder, or duplicate them in another destination, resulting in multiple copies of the same files, which can lead to confusion later on. Make sure to check the import settings and preferences for your recording devices and any application you might be using to review or import your data, so you know where it is going and how to find it. File structure. You might end up with an organization structure that looks like this, with all media of a single type, such as sound recordings in one folder, all video in another, and XML files in yet another folder. In this situation, you must make sure you can match each file to any related files, versions, or derivative files. You might bucket materials in multiple folders, or keep them all in one directory, but give the media files meaningful names based on a particular file naming scheme. Some archives may require you to rename your files. However you organize your data, it's essential that you keep track of how all the materials go together, such as video files, audio files, and their transcriptions. If you have a project that you know will be going into a specific archive, determine early on how they would like those materials organized for deposit, so you can map out that organizational structure before you start collecting your data. This will lessen the work in the long run. For more videos like this one, check out Isla's channel.